Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Life is Strange. It is that time again. Episode 4 is finally here, and I cannot wait to jump in and see what the heck is going on in the world of Life is Strange. Last episode was just so, it was a normal episode until the very end, where it turned out we could time travel. We, changed things. We went back in time and forward in time, and it was like, what? And Chloe was in a wheelchair, and it was just, it was crazy. So, I have no idea what's gonna happen.
Previously on Life is Strange.
Whoa.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Don't ever touch me again, freak! Let's talk about your superpower.
What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us. Miss Caulfield, please, tell us everything.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
Max, we have to find Rachel soon.
Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues. Welcome to my domain. Let's find what we want and beat it.
Max, you better come check out these files.
Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it.
Listen, I found pictures of Rachel and Frank. Being more than friends.
I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
No, you don't.
Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? Ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
Hello, are you even listening, Maxine?
This is totally fucked up. What else have I changed?
Max Caulfield, hold on. Chloe, you have a visitor.
Life is Strange is a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of all your in-game actions and decisions will impact the past, present, and future. Choose wisely. Last episode really hammered that home with the whole past, present, and future thing, didn't it? Jeez! Life is Strange, Episode 4, Dark Room. So this is the five-part series. This is the second-to-last episode right here. They've got a lot of answering to do in these last two episodes.
It's weird hanging out with you again.
I know. I'm glad we are, though.
It was nice that you sent me actual letters. It's more than any of my other friends have done. And you even wrote on that cool parchment paper. It's so Max.
So pretentious.
but I love writing on it like an English poet. You deserve the best stationery. Probably easier to write than to visit me. I don't mean that in a bitchy way. Not totally. You probably wanted to avoid awkward conversations like this.
Pretty much, yeah.
Look, the worst thing you can do is treat me like a baby. I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend. Can we stop? This is seriously the best view of the sunset. What do photographers call that?
The golden hour.
See? Without you here, I'd have no clue. Bet you could take some amazing shots. Those beached whales are so sad. I kind of know how they feel. At least, I'm alive here with you.
You're a real survivor, Chloe. I know you have to deal with so much.
I don't want anybody else feeling sorry for me. I can do that. Along with my parents. My dad still feels guilty about buying me that car.
Do we talk about the accident or do we blame William? I don't think blaming William is the way to go. I think we talk about the accident.
Are you okay to talk about the accident?
We never actually have, huh? There's not much to say. Some prick in an SUV cut me off and I flew into a ditch.
Do you remember everything?
I saw everything in bullet time. I felt my back snap and that was the last thing I ever felt in my body. When I woke up in the hospital, I literally couldn't move a muscle.
Jesus. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. I'm just happy I did get to see you again. I could have ended up vanishing out of the blue like that girl from Blackwell.
What girl missing? Or Rachel? We know it's Rachel. You mean Rachel?
You mean Rachel Amber? When was the last time you talked to her?
Never. I just read about her in the news. I didn't even know her name. You did?
This is such a different world than when we were kids, isn't it?
After that snow and eclipse, it's more like the end of the world.
Do you think so? I haven't kept up with the details.
I have more time on my hands than you. Plus, I'm a science nerd. But none of this makes sense.
I know things seem out of control, but as long as we're together, I don't feel afraid.
Hanging out with you makes me feel like a total kid again. You don't even know.
Listen, Chloe, I'm sorry I haven't been out to see you more. That was wrong. You're my best friend.
Max, thanks for coming out to see me. You're doing awesome.
I don't think so.
My nose is getting cold. Maybe we should get back to my place?
It is hella cold out here.
Hella? I hate that word, no offense.
None taken.
So, can we not just look at like a photo of, well, I'm guessing there wasn't a photo of Chloe near the time of the accident, go back and stop it? Is that how this works? Do we not have any photos of Chloe like somewhat near the accident? I doubt there were any like in real time. I doubt anyone was taking photos of the accident, but maybe like a day before, a week? Or do we just have to live in this future now? Is that it? Is everything changed?
Oh, it's a pretty high-tech lair.
Feels like a high-tech cell. But I am lucky my parents bust their ass to take care of me. I know it's hard for them.
They're grateful you're here with them.
Right. Especially when they can't even take a walk alone. Sometimes I act like a total teenage brat just to give them an excuse to yell at me. Pathetic, I know.
Chloe, you're a great daughter. You're kind and sensitive, when you don't even have to be.
Trust me, I still get my rage on. Especially when a nurse has to watch while I take a dump so she can wipe my bum. Or when doctors flip me around like I was a science doll.
I can't even imagine. But you're still amazing. You always have been since we were kids.
Thanks again for coming, Max. I need to get my drink on. Can you bring me some water?
Sure thing, Chloe. All right.
I still can't believe I put Chloe in that chair.
This is it. This is where we need to find a picture. We got a board.
Chloe's message board since the accident sure looks lonely. I didn't add much. Man, Joyce and William
gas masks optional
bathroom for Chloe. They're so great. I should offer to put makeup on for Chloe. Not that I can, but it would be fun. Chloe is still a punk at heart. But she can't stage dive anymore.
I love how we do this.
It's so cool that Chloe has made friends online.
I love how we just look through people's computers when they're just sat like right across the room. We do it every time. Miss Blue, so what are you doing? Talking with you. Haha, no shit. I'm about to binge Quantum Leap. OMG, love. It's got the Bakula rules. So do you. I hope we can meet soon. Not if you're in San Francisco. Hey, I have to take care of some body work. Let me get back to you in a while. You're bringing on Bakula. You're better. Hello? Alright. What's this?
Whoa. Chloe can totally control her computer. It's so great people get this high-tech help. There's the old Chloe.
Max, it is so cool that you're here again.
Drink up, Buttercup.
Oh, man. No wonder my throat is dry. I don't think I've talked this much the whole year.
Have you ever thought about doing a podcast or something?
I wish I could punch your face right now. A podcast? Dude, I am a pod in a cast. Boring.
Ouch. It was just a thought.
I know you're just trying to help.
Yeah, that's become a bad habit of mine.
You sound like an adult now. Seems like we were kids in another life.
What do you remember? You're right. Seems like yesterday. What do you remember?
What do you remember about us as kids? We all have different memories.
I think about us as little pirates running and jumping through Arcadia Bay.
Me too. But we're still pirates in our own way.
Yeah, right. Check me out, Chloe of the Caribbean. No way will I get on a fucking boat now. Unless you're with me. As you can see, I can't keep all my other friends away.
I don't want to say which friends. That just sounds rude. We'll say you have me.
I'm not leaving you, Chloe.
Well, you didn't visit me a lot either. I mean, I loved your cards and photos, but...
I know I wasn't around much. No excuses, I'm a loser. But I am trying to make things right.
How? Dude, you're not Supermax. And I'm not trying to guilt trip you. That's what my parents are for.
Where's the option to say I am Supermax and we can tell her all about our powers and we can be like, I'm gonna save you in the world, but no. They love you. We'll be nice.
They love you so much.
I know. My mom and dad are so cute. They always pop in here and make sure everything's okay with me.
I think Joyce and William are incredible.
Max, the accident has been so hard on them. Our insurance sucks and the medical bills are fucking insane.
Can they pay all the bills?
No way. They keep the numbers away from me, but it doesn't take much research to find out I'm costing my parents almost $1 million a year.
Chloe, you're priceless. No pun intended.
You're such a geek. That's why I love you. Of course, I know a geek when I be one. See, I'm practically a human entertainment system. It would be sweet to chill out together and watch a movie like when you'd spend the night at my house.
What do you want to watch?
I think I'm in like a mellow Blade Runner mood. I always cry at the end. Plus, you know I always wanted to have cool colored bangs like Pris.
I know. You would look incredible with blue hair. Now let's get this show on the road. And you better not fall asleep on me like you always do when we watch movies.
I remember, Max. Swear I won't fall asleep. Not when you're here. Not yet.
Okay. Oh gosh, look at this. Snow globes.
Snow globes are taking over.
Why so many snow globes? You know, I never got snow globes. Not a huge fan. All right, what else we got? Teddy bear.
Hello, Chloe. She likes fluffy animals now.
I know, right? Is there anything else we can kind of find? Oh, what the heck?
That's a serious heat lamp.
Okay.
Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood? She can't even feel the grass now.
We'll just go through your drawers. One second, Chloe.
Wowzer.
Oh, jeez, look at this.
A straight A student.
Isn't everything?
She could have gone to any college. Gutless bastard. I am so glad Chloe stole your bullshit fund. Even if it wasn't another reality.
However, given that the campus and building have all been constructed pre-1977, our school has not yet undergone much of... Basically, we got a letter here saying that, hi, we understand Chloe's condition, but no, because the building's really old, I'm assuming we're not allowed to redo it. Renovations necessary, yada, yada, yada. You can't come to Blackwell Academy. What a massive ding-dong. All right, what else we got?
Despite everything, they're still a happy family again. It's cool that in this reality, Chloe really loves skating, too.
Okay, that's a nice TV you got there, Chloe. I must say.
This is so cool that you're here again.
I know, you said that already. So. They're like, what, 42 inch, maybe? All right, let's have a look. Oh, jeez.
Here's the DVD.
I cannot believe you fell asleep so fast. How dare you? I know you were beat down after the day with me. And Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No. I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me.
You are a bitch in the morning.
It's the company I keep. Yesterday was such a blast.
It was great seeing you.
I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates, jumping and running through the forests again. It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit. I'm getting my regular head pains. Can you pretty please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom?
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep this wag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. Like a pirate, right?
I'm on it, Chloe.
Okay. I mean, not through that guy, but if your parents don't want you to get it, is me getting it more? Oh, look, your parents are here. Hi, Chloe's dad.
Hey, William. Am I bothering you?
Why, yes, Max. I love going through bills. Kidding. How can you bother me? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. You look exactly the same. It's so cool.
Good. Or I'd be scared if I didn't look like me. Of course, you seem more adult now. So what's on your mind?
Karen, Chloe, Joyce, leave. We'll talk about Chloe.
I don't know how to say this, but I'm truly sorry about what happened to Chloe.
Me too. All it takes is a few minutes to change a girl's whole life. But she's alive. She's been a trooper.
Is she mad at me? Glad you're here. I don't know why she'd be mad at me. Actually, she might be. We haven't been in a long time.
Is she mad at me for not staying in touch? She should be. I have no excuse.
She was disappointed, but she knows you care. And I know how hard it is to process all this. It's taken us years.
William, I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll always be here for Chloe. Always.
I know you will, Max.
I was impressed by Chloe's room and all the high-tech equipment.
You should be. We could buy a few mansions for what it all costs. Insurance helps, but I don't know, Max.
I know it must be hard on you guys financially.
These bills are more like crushing. We have to mortgage our home, and that's pretty scary. But we'll get through it. Price is always right. Get it? No?
Being around you and Joyce again is so nostalgic.
Very old school, as they say. I think it's great for Chloe to see you. Makes Joyce happy, too. So, it's not all bad news in Arcadia Bay. Or is it?
Crazy weather? You know anything about Rachel Amber?
I was reading about that missing girl. Rachel Amber?
Oh, yes. She went to Blackwell, right? Oh, poor thing. That's a real nightmare for a family. I get scared thinking about Chloe and that we might lose her someday.
What do you know about the Prescott family?
The Prescott family might be bad news. What do you think about them?
Evil. Next question.
Sounds
glad we're on the same page.
More than I want to. But Joyce has to work for those greedy bastards at Pan Estates. I don't even like to think about it.
What do you think is going on with all of this crazy weather and animals dying?
Nobody knows, right? It is Nostradamus-type shit, pardon my French. But all I actually care about now is Chloe and Joyce. My family.
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything. It was so great talking with you again.
You act like it's the last time. And please, keep me from these bills whenever you want.
Okay. We got two new texts from Victoria. Come to my room tonight. Max, are we cool? I just wanted to make sure since you walked away so fast. Nathan was worried too. If you want to talk, hit me up, okay? Love you. Max, if you're mad, just tell me, okay? Silence, so you want to talk. My door is open. Love you. So if you want to talk, my door is open. Love you. Okay. Chloe, we just got a smiley face. Oh, Alicia. Where are these? Maybe it's time to go digital. I'll call you later. Are these new texts or are these old texts from before? I assume they have to be new texts.
Choice is a food coupon, boss.
Okay, where's this morphine at? I'm assuming Joyce is at work.
They're drowning in debt just to take care of their daughter. Such bullshit.
Your joint account has been closed and is now 6 months overdue. Please send a check or money order to for $3,458 payable to Happy Credit Card. Well, that just sounds like a great thing, doesn't it? Jeez, look at that. We can reinstate Chloe at a standard rate of $1,250 per week. It's a bargain, guys. It's a bargain.
Joyce and William never had a garage sale before.
Oh, jeez. So I wonder what Chloe's room has been turned into then. Oh gosh, this looks a lot less happy than the last time we came. Is this one Chloe's room? Yep.
A blue butterfly? I'm sure this is a total coincidence.
Or is it, Max?
At least we never had to hide from Step Douche.
That's true.
I never heard much about William's brother.
Hi, Bill. Sorry for not staying in touch since the accident. Work has been piling up, and I've been sent to Salt Lake City to oversee the new parking lot. You have to go where the work is these days. I wish I could have sent you a bigger check, but you know the story. Money is no one's favorite thing. Maybe I'll see you next spring for a visit. Kiss Chloe and Joyce from me. Hang in there, Billy. Your brother, Aaron. Or Aaron.
Toys? I kind of want to open this and see what's in here. They bought crutches for Chloe, hoping she might walk again. Too bad Joyce and William can't get any help from the Prescott Foundation.
Dear Joyce, thank you for keeping me updated on Chloe's condition. I can only imagine the struggle you and William are going through. I'm so sorry that I can't help you with the loan at this time. Like everybody else, I'm underwater with my own medical bills. Please give Chloe a hug and my best wishes. Love, Aunt Dorothy. Alright. Where is the morphine? Oh, hi, Joyce.
It is so nice to have you around.
I assumed you were out.
Good morning, Max. Oh, you and Chloe are so much quieter now than when you were kids.
I remember. It's nice waking up in your house again.
Oh, William and I love it. Finally seeing you and Chloe together after all these years. After the accident.
I wish I was a better friend. I know Chloe doesn't get many visitors.
Oh, Max, you're Chloe's best friend for a reason. You're here exactly when she needs you.
Chloe needs help?
Who helps Chloe out when you guys are at work?
We have a series of revolving nurses and caretakers. Chloe still causes trouble, even if she can't move. Max, Chloe's condition is not improving. Her respiratory system is very weak, and do you know what I'm saying?
Joyce. I'm so sorry you have to go through all this.
Bad or good, I embrace every moment with my daughter and my husband. This is what it means to be a family. And we'll always be one. No matter what.
I have to tell you how much I love seeing you and William together again.
He's been such a hero through all this. Chloe and I, lucky to have him.
Is William still the same?
Is William still the same? After everything that's happened?
For better and for worse. But always for the better. I never thought I'd love a man so much I can't imagine life without him.
Unfortunately, we can.
I know.
You rule, Joyce.
Shit. Things would be different if I did. I like how you think, kid.
How are you doing, Joyce?
I'm doing the best I can, Max. I won't lie, it's difficult, but nobody said life was easy here in Arcadia Bay.
Lot of work? David Madison? Echo Havoc. We'll talk about David.
Do you know somebody named David Madison? He, might hang out at the Two Whales.
Well, that was random. Yeah, he's a bus driver. He comes in sometimes. Cute, quiet. Why?
Oh, I was just curious.
You always were. Nice to see that everything doesn't change.
What's Eco Havoc? Oh, is that the whales dying?
What do you think is going on here with all of this Eco Havoc?
Maybe Arcadia Bay just wants to be left alone. I know the feeling.
Oh, sorry,
honestly,
Joyce.
I don't give a shit about too much outside our house.
I don't blame you, Joyce.
Except now we have dead birds and beach whales outside our front door. So maybe I should care, for Chloe's sake.
I think we're just gonna leave.
I better get back to Chloe now. It's good talking with you, Joyce.
You too, honey.
She seemed to be pretty adamant about knowing the idea of wanting to be left alone. All right, this is clearly not the right room. Okay. Eeny, meeny, miny. Well, this one's just open. This has to be the right way, right? Oh. Why, hello. How are you doing? I'm not seeing any morphine. It might be. Oh. There we go.
Nothing here.
Okay.
It's cool that Chloe uses natural medicine too. The bathroom looks almost the same. Just more medicine.
Here we go.
Here it is.
Oh, wow.
I never thought I'd be delivering morphine to my best friend.
You know, I cannot say I've ever thought that I would be doing that either. But, hey, we will go back downstairs. Alright, Chloe, where you at? I don't want to rewind! Stop the rewinding! I accidentally hit control! Okay.
I'm not gonna say fucking.
Chloe's dad's chatting to himself, that's fine. Hey, Chloe. You okay? Here you go.
Finally. Give me the blue pill. I'm sorry. I'm nosy, but not precise. Go ahead and plug it right in. It's so easy. And painless. Okay, but get ready to yell for your folks if I screw up. Oh, trust me. I will. Of course, my pain just keeps getting worse. But you caught me on a good day. Max, I'm so grateful that I'm even able to hang out with you. See, I'm getting mushy. I'm already high. You're so adorable. Do you want anything else? Stop me if I'm being too emo. But can you grab one of the photo albums over there? I'd like to check out some old pictures of us when we were kids. Please. My diary is like emo ground zero. Plus, Max Caulfield does not pass up a photo op with Chloe Price.
Oh, yeah. All right, where are these photos at? We got a snow globe still. Draw is in here. Did you say on the side, didn't she? Oh, look at this photo album. All right, we are going to grab this photo album because Chloe wants to go all emo and start looking at it, which is fine. She's not too well right now. Something has to happen this episode. I know I said it last time, but something has to happen. We have to fix this. Somehow.
Is that okay?
Perfect. Oh my god. Look how little we are there. We look like toys.
I remember that day by the lighthouse.
My dad was pissed at us. He actually tried to give us a timeout.
And you laughed at him. My dad would have banished me.
I don't think we've met our own parents yet, have we? Like, we've met Chloe's parents and her alternate parents in the universe where her dad doesn't die.
Awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance.
There's still time for you.
Oh, this is it. We're looking at photo album. She's going to be like, oh, this is the photo of me right before the accident. Wink, wink.
Oh, man. There we are making pancakes. I love that shot of us. It's hard to believe my dad took that picture only 5 years ago.
Literally seems like yesterday.
I wish it was.
Me too. This photo. Maybe I could.
I told you. Please don't take me back to where I went before, though.
Listen, can't make me choose
between this reality and the old one.
My respiratory system is failing, and it's only getting worse.
I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out. So, I know I'm just putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along. And I will too. This isn't how I want things to end.
What? What are you saying?
I'm saying that being with you again has been so special. I just wanted to feel like when we were kids running around Arcadia Bay and everything was possible, and you made me feel that way today. I want this time with you to be my last memory. Do you understand?
Yes, I do.
All you have to do is crank up the IV to 11.
What? You can't make me do this game! Oh! Can we go back? Oh, God. This is like the worst decision in a game ever. Although, if it was me, and I was the person in Chloe's shoes, and I'd asked Max to do it, I'd want her to accept.
Chloe, I'll just drift asleep, dreaming of us here together, forever. Thank you so much. I'm so proud of you for following your dreams. Don't forget about me.
Never.
I love you, Max. See you around.
Sooner than you think.
I mean, we can always rewind, right? If things get really bad. Because, I mean, not to put a damper on the mood, but we did just break the law. In, like, everywhere in the world. Oh, here we go.
I'm sorry, William.
What? Okay, so we gotta, like, move the mouse. I think left. Are we gonna get clear? Am I doing this right? I think it's... Is it? I think I have to move the mouse and try and get this in focus. I know we did this last episode, game, but it's been like 9 months since you released the last episode of this, so if you could tell me how to do this again, that would be fantastic. It's just blurring in and out. This is not game. Okay, that's really blurry. Okay, I think I'm... Okay, I thought Okay. We get to perfect. Right, that's blurry. There we go. We gotta get it. I'm using the WASD here. If I go too far that way, it goes blurry. If I go too far in the D direction, it goes blurry. So we gotta get it like smack bang in the middle. And then we gotta use the up and down to get that perfectly in the middle as well. It's too blurry. Oh, come on now. Is this right? There we go! So are we gonna go back and just let William leave?
Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper. Hello? Hey, honey. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund. Aha! You can't hide from me forever. And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
Dad!
Don't blow it, because tonight
we can't come back
to make us a world famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert.
By Max, burning the photo, we can't come back.
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. Like you're never gonna see us again.
Chloe, I'm so sorry. I tried to make things different for you. I did try. I'm sorry.
I don't know exactly what you're talking about, but come on. You have made things different, like my whole life. You're my best friend. I've got you and a great family. What's to be sorry for? We'll be best friends forever. And when we grow up, we're taking over the world.
Listen, whatever happens, I want you to be strong. Even if you feel like I wasn't there for you. Because I will never abandon you, Chloe. I'll always have your back. Always.
What I want to know is, did we change anything by talking at the end there? Because we wouldn't have said those things to Chloe if we'd have known. But like the last time when we didn't, I don't know. It's time travel. Oh, it's so confusing. I'm assuming that now we are back in the reality that we were in originally. Like nothing has changed to the, not, I assume so. But that could be just completely wrong.
Max, you get one kiss, now you're all over me.
I'm so glad you're here.
You sound high, but thanks for the morning grope. Since we were up all night playing CSI Arcadia Bay, I was still spaced out here trying to put all this info together. Max, did you forget we've gone over this? I hope you weren't messing around with time while I was sleeping.
Not anymore.
You could say that.
I'm spaced out too. Welcome back to the real world, Max.
Oh, it's good to be back. I mean, we killed so many people.
Let's look at all our pieces in the puzzle so far.
Let's look at the what? Oh, the board here. Okay. Oh, we're trying to find out what happened to Rachel, aren't we? I completely forgot what we were doing back in normal time, because we killed William, Chloe's father, after killing Chloe in the old universe,
so
and we
close,
just
yet so far away.
Everything.
We have to do three main things.
Right. What things?
One, decipher Frank's logbook. Two, get Nathan's phone to find out where he's been during the Vortex Club parties with Kate and Rachel. And see whatever hidden shit he's got in his messages.
Three, beat Step Douche Dan until he tells us about Frank, Nathan, and the Darkroom.
And I do have a gun now.
Keep it in your pants. We'll have to do this on our own.
Dude, at least let me kick his ass, then rewind. Fine, whatevs. It's your power.
Which I can't waste on shit like that. Or Blackwell would be in big trouble.
At least you let me take that money to pay Frank off.
Don't remind me. I just want him off your back. Our back.
I know. You should get busy in the garage to see what dirt you can dig up. I'm gonna cyberstalk some names and see where that leads. Or to who. And be careful of Stepcrack. He's not gonna be a happy camper after you reamed him yesterday and Mom is giving him the boot.
I'm on it, partner.
Okay. So... I don't know what she was gonna say. Stepdad's not happy with me, and we're gonna go start snooping around all his stuff. That seems like a good idea. Seems like a good idea. What could possibly go wrong? Hi. Goodbye.
You won this battle, Max. You broke up my family. I salute you.
David, I didn't try to hurt you. Ever. But I won't let anybody hurt Chloe.
Too late, isn't it? You just better be damn careful with her. Don't you wander off into the dark.
That seemed like a bit of a thinly veiled threat.
Looks like David already booked a room.
No point in us sitting down, really. No one's here. Oh, we got some texts from Warren. Okay. In this case, Max, yes, my folks will... something. These texts... I don't even get this. We'll wait till it's finished, shall we? Cool. Okay. Let's try this again. What is there? My folks will shit. Yo, yo, Max! My friend Chloe texted me that I'm out of the loop now. She sounds hot. So I guess why. She sounds hot, so I guess why. I get why. Okay. Okay. Chloe actually texted you? I sure don't have her number. At least I get to go ape with you. Unless you want to chill with Chloe. Or we could all go. One pain in the ass is enough. Cool. I have to jet. TTYL. Talk to you later. So Chloe's texting Warren now. Okay.
It looks like David finished his car repairs. Maybe there's some new clues around.
I'd assume that David would take his things with him before he leaves. I don't know. Let's check the email.
Should I have signed the petition? Blackwell sure isn't safe and private anymore.
Despite our rather heated discussion about the successful petition to block our campus surveillance system, I am still interested in your feedback on other methods of improving Blackwell security. We must find a middle ground between safety and privacy for our students. I thought we did sign it.
Grant, twist that knife.
I didn't need a surveillance camera to see this suspension coming. Best of luck, Mr. Grant.
Ooh. At least he has one weird fan.
Dear Mr. Madison, who's sending him this? From Anonymous. I just want to let you know that I think it's bullshit what happened to you. And this school has had too many libtard metrosexuals who don't appreciate you or the military. I felt safe in my dorm when you were in charge as a student, and I thought about you protecting me. I hope you will come back to Blackwell and make sure we're all safe at night. I'm scared of this school.
Wish I had surveillance footage of that conversation.
I apologize for my outburst yesterday in your office. Who's this from? This is from David Madison to Mr. Wells, to the head of Blackpool. Blackpool? To the head of Blackwell. I was upset about you losing my position at Black Belt without a complete investigation of the facts and based solely on the claims of untrustworthy students. I think he's talking about maybe some of us there. There is a cancer at Blackwell Academy, and without me, it will continue to spread. Ooh, David's firing some shots everywhere.
Surveillance cameras at Pan Estates? David must be working for the Prescotts, too.
Oh, that makes sense. Put all the bad guys into one room.
Oh, that makes me sad. It was so incredible to see William again. I wish Chloe could too. Either Chloe stole another gun, or David is out there armed.
It wouldn't surprise me if David was out there armed.
What the hell did David do for Nathan? And what did his dad do for David?
Thank you for your help with Nathan. It is appreciated. Best, Sean Prescott. Ooh. Maybe David got him out of the whole situation with the gun?
I wonder if David is going to the party.
The Vortex Club party? Maybe. I mean, it'd be a bit weird. He's a bit older than everybody else. There doesn't look to be much else in there. There's a door over there. We'll check over. Ooh, there's a locker, and it's locked.
Whoa, that is a serious padlock on that locker. Hey, David, what you hiding?
Am I supposed to know this number?
For once, I don't have time to search for the code. Oh, I need to find a way to break this padlock.
Okay, here we go. Yeah, okay. Crowbar.
I can use that crowbar to pry open the locker.
Is that after we've broken the lock or before we break the lock? Crowbar.
Sorry, David, but I bet you would do the same thing as me. Oh, maps, notes, coordinates, photos of Kate, Nathan. Oh, yes.
What? First of all, it's creepy as heck having pictures of your students. What? These are like times, dates, coordinates? What the heck? Number plates? Pictures of me? What the heck?
Score. Back to Chloe now.
Can we get back in through this door? Oh, we can. Look at that. I didn't even know about that door.
Yo, Chloe! Are you ready yet? I have to get back to my dorm.
Are we happy?
Very happy. I hit the secret file jackpot. Kate, Nathan, and Rachel. Plus some location coordinates. David is like a one-man surveillance army. Now let's get the hell out of here before we get busted.
Now let's go find out what Nathan is hiding in his room.
We have to be extra careful.
Max, now it's time for Nathan Prescott to be afraid of us.
So we're back at Blackwell. We're gonna go search up Nathan's room. See what we can find. Now one thing we need to do this episode that we haven't done in like the last three episodes is talk to people, because we get to the end and then there's like 50 different options that we didn't even look at.
Hey,
because
Max,
we just walked past everyone.
Oh, hi Mr. Jefferson. I'm okay. And this is my friend Chloe.
Yeah.
Chloe? Why isn't somebody as cool as you going to Blackwell?
I was way too cool for this school. It's a long story. In actual files here.
I can imagine. Max, are you sure that you're all right?
It's weird just being on campus like everything's normal.
I know. Lame as it sounds, life has to go on.
I think there's too much going on in my life.
On that note, Blackwell duty calls. Remember, I'm going to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes contest tonight at the party. So I hope you'll be there to celebrate, even though I'm sorry you didn't enter a photo. I understand your reasons. You can't force an artist to work.
I feel like a total loser, but it's been a hard week to focus. No pun intended.
I'm proud of you for caring so much about a troubled friend, and I take hope in the fact that you have plenty of time to find your way. Just get in the habit of putting your work out there.
Thanks, Mr. Jefferson. I'll definitely be there tonight.
Me too. I'll be Max's date. You better dance with us at least once.
Nobody should have to see me dance. Plus, you don't want to watch the old hipster trying to keep up with the kids. I have some pride. Be seeing you.
Yes, you will. Hot for teacher.
Gross! You're out of control.
Not yet. Just wait until the rager tonight.
Shut up.
Don't be jealous because Mark Jefferson thinks I'm cool.
I am so ignoring you.
Fine. Since I'm here, I'll see if I can get some dirt from Justin. I haven't talked to him in a while.
Now that is a great plan.
Okay.
Let's talk to some people. Let's see if I can find out where Nathan is.
Hey, sorry to interrupt. Do you mind? Can we talk? Can we? I'd like.
Hey,
hello.
Since you.
No. Okay. Is it far to? I like it. Okay. Alessa, you. Why do you play hard to get when you already hard to want? That's just mean. Okay. Who we got over here?
I had to clear away another batch of dead birds today.
Oh, not the dead birds.
Max, you always show up when I'm talking about you.
Well.
I'm still bragging about you and the other students making Blackwell surveillance free.
Nathan K., recent events?
I was hoping you could explain some of these crazy things happening in Arcadia Bay.
If I could, I'd be collecting my Nobel Prize in Science today. I haven't been able to wrap my mind around that eclipse, much less the snow in Wales.
Beyond science? Scientific explanation?
There must be a scientific explanation, right?
When my friends at NASA tell me they can't explain a solar eclipse without a single theory as to how or why, maybe it's time to get worried. Like they are.
I am worried about reality. I feel like it's changing right in front of us.
You and Samuel both. We were talking about that before you came over. Our planet is changing, but it's not mystic. It's erosion.
Prophecy or dying animals? What was with the arm movements there at the end? Dying animals.
You think that's why all these animals are dying here?
Well, our shoreline has been receding. Not to mention the daily contamination of the ocean. That's all you need to kill off sea and wildlife here. Unless you know something I don't.
Time travel? Tabanga? I could time travel.
What about wormholes and chaos theory? I like time travel stuff.
The only wormholes in Arcadia Bay are underground. And chaos theory is just that. But if this is about time travel, sign me up.
Would you really change time?
Not after reading that Bradbury story, A Sound of Thunder. I won't give it away, but it involves dinosaurs and butterflies. Time is like a thread, Max. One tug and it all can unravel.
That's comforting.
I don't think surveillance would have helped Kate Marsh.
Oh, Max. I'm so sorry you had to go through that. Kate was the sweetest student I've ever met at Blackwell. And they can be so cruel to each other. Do you need to talk to a counselor?
No thanks, Blackwell needs help. No thanks.
No thanks, Miss Grant. I have my best friend and my parents. For now.
I'm happy to hear that, Max. Just don't ever be afraid to talk to somebody, okay? I wish Kate had come to me. I had no idea what she was going through.
Kate was drugged at the Vortex Club party and bullied by them until she ended up on the roof. How do you stop that?
Shut down that damn Vortex Club for a start. I don't mean to get riled up, but that party should have been postponed. It's extremely tasteless given what happened with Kate.
The Prescotts? We'll talk about Principal Wells. I think he's partly to blame
why
here.
Why doesn't Principal Wells stop the party? To be honest, he doesn't seem to care about what's going on here.
Raymond Wells has saved this school from financial disaster, and he cares more than you know. You're wise. But don't be so quick to judge everybody.
You're right. I just wish this could be the school that I dreamed about before I came here.
I hear you, Max. I love seeing you and Warren and all my students at your best here. But you're all too young to be so cynical. But you truly give me hope.
I was looking for Nathan Prescott, and I thought he might be in your class.
Mr. Prescott has no class at all after his suspension. I didn't think you were friends.
Hell no. You know him better?
You probably know him better.
I've tried. Nathan is a Prescott, and with that comes a lot of baggage. Too much for one teenager. This week was the proof.
Principal Wells did the right thing.
I know. Nathan needs real help.
Yes, he does, Max. I did try once, but Mr. Prescott didn't appreciate my help. I did see Nathan leaving the campus looking angrier than usual, so maybe it's good you haven't found him.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant. I have to get going. I'll see you later.
It's always good talking to you, Max.
Good. Nathan is not around. I should go back to Chloe.
Okay. I'm going to talk to you. You look like you have a different ending that we can unlock.
Hey, Brooke. How are you?
Considering what happened to Kate,
that we can unlock.
I could be better. Are you okay?
I'm good. Nathan Drone Wales leave. I'll talk about Nathan.
I need to find Nathan. Have you seen him around?
Ask Warren. I mean, you're going to the movies with him and everything.
Come on, Brooke. Don't be that way. Nathan was suspended, but he should still be on campus.
Warren's not good enough for you? Okay. I saw Nathan pissed and walking off campus earlier. Good luck getting that date, Max.
Life's not all about dates, Brooke. I'm leaving. This woman.
Talk
Jeez.
Later, Brooke.
That's so ironic that Warren asked Max to the drive-in.
Okay. I'm guessing we can't talk to you guys throwing the ball. Oh, we can. We can look at him.
Enjoy the big game, Zachary. I hope it's not the last.
And I guess we can't jump. I guess we can go talk to this guy with the gloves.
Time to go clean up graffiti for... How are you doing, Max? Been a tough week. I know.
Yes, it has, Samuel. How are you?
Sad and confused, like everybody else in Arcadia Bay. You look like you have a lot of questions, too.
We'll talk about people.
More questions than answers.
Samuel is always here to talk.
It's a little bit creepy, but we'll keep going. We'll talk about Nathan again.
Have you seen Nathan Prescott around?
That would be hard since he was suspended.
You don't sound sad. He deserved it.
You don't sound sad, Samuel.
Nathan hurts people. The end.
What do you really know about him?
Not enough to help you, Max. I truly wish I could. I see what you're doing.
Talk about David.
Do you ever talk with David Madsen?
He talks to me. I listen.
That's how David operates.
He sees things, not people. But I think he sees you, Max.
Why?
Why do you say that?
Because you both see with cameras.
I think you have better vision than both of us.
No, Max. I just look at everything from a different angle.
Blackwell is so sad and quiet since Kate isn't here anymore.
Yes. You can tell that the campus is different now. And you reached out to her when everybody turned away.
Destiny?
It could have gone either way. Samuel, do you think that we each have a destiny?
Yes, I do, Max. In many different lifetimes, of course. Kate Marsh believed in something different, so that's her destiny.
I believe you.
Kate just needed some more helpful spirits like her friend Max. I hope she finds them now.
I definitely have questions about what's happening to the animals in Arcadia Bay.
Oh, many do. These poor creatures have no choice in what happens to them.
Squirrel? Dead birds? You were talking about dead birds.
What do you think about all those dying birds?
Samuel had to bury dozens near the Tabanga.
He talks about himself in the third person, which is just, it just adds to the creepiness. What happened? What's Tabanga?
Is that cool with the Tabanga?
We'll find out if the souls of the bird move on. Not we can prove it.
It's so ominous.
Unless it's fate, then it doesn't matter.
Okay.
I'm sorry. I better get going.
We need to go. We need to go search Nathan's dorm. Now we need to talk to Chloe. Because we know Nathan's not around. And we got stuff to do. Cool handshake.
Coast is clear.
It would be so cool if you and me were going to school here together.
But now you can have Mr. Jefferson all to yourself.
Ugh, you suck. Now let's get into Blackwell ninja mode.
Okay, so we're gonna go see what we can find in Nathan's dorm room. I'm not quite sure how we're gonna pull that off without anyone seeing us.
So lame, they don't have co-ed dorms here.
Yes, because I want Nathan Prescott in the room next door.
Good point.
Wait here. Give me the signal if Nathan or anybody shows up.
I won't let you down, Batmax.
Now I just have to find Nathan's room.
That shouldn't be too hard. Oh, there we go. Oh, okay. The Vortex Club sucks ass. I doubt that's Nathan's room. We got showers.
They have one more meeting left.
Okay. Skateboarding is not a crime. Got another slate. Can I has art? 106. Toilet paper. I'm hoping, let's see here. We got Bigfoot's got big balls. That could be Nathan's room. I'm going to try and do it just by looking at the slates here. It's all good in the woods. The Prescott's rule this town. Is that Nathan's?
This can only be Nathan's room.
If that is Nathan's room, that's just a stupid, stupid sign to have on the outside. How is no one hearing this? Is everyone out right now? Oh, geez, look at this. He's got a projector. And the world's biggest projector screen. Okay.
Now I
clues.
Need to find Nathan's phone.
We need his phone.
Anything with clues.
Where would his phone be? That would be in his drawers. Well, we can look at everything anyway.
I don't think this prescription has helped Nathan. I thought Victoria had the photo bling, but once again, the Prescott's rule. That's so cute and ironic.
The best son in the world.
I can't believe Nathan still has it around.
Nathan Prescott. 2006. That's an old diploma.
That monochrome camera is brand new and costs about $6,000. Bastard. Nathan clearly has his fetish down. That is so Chloe.
I need to switch over. Hey, so we need to talk. I'm going to tell everyone what you did, and you're going to pay, motherfucker. What did he do? What does Chloe know? Oh, gosh. MP3.
Whale songs? Maybe this is the only soothing thing Nathan ever hears. That must be the lamp Chloe broke when Nathan drugged her. I don't think one book can guide the Prescotts.
Rage On, a teen/parent guide to anger management by Dr. Bill. I mean, I don't think it did work. Not gonna lie, Nathan's a bit rageful.
Damn, Nathan. That's a nice shot. If only all your energy. It's so damn creepy, but the guy has his own style. Oh, Jesus. Nathan is one sick fuck.
We've got to use this computer. This has got to be like where
Nathan
the stuff is.
Nathan is way into this party.
Let's have a look.
Bad sign.
What's up? By Victoria Chase from Nathan Prescott. Oh, so this is Nathan sending an email to Victoria. I thought it was the other way around. Hey, gorgeous. Let me know what you're wearing to the Vortex party so I can wear something just as styling and expensive. I'm psyched about going and I picked up some serious party favors. I even told my dad to keep the pigs away from Blackwell so we can get wrecked without hassle. If we're going to have an end of the world theme, then let's do it fucking on point, right? I mean, sure.
Bastard. Now I remember why I hate you and why Kate will get justice.
Okay.
Oh man. Sean Prescott might be Nathan's real problem.
Don't worry, from Sean Prescott to Nathan Prescott. Nate, I know it's been a stressful week for you and your mother, and I am and I are here to talk. What? I am here to talk, as I assume what I meant to put there. If need be, just make an appointment anytime. Your mother wants Dr. Bill to come out after his book tour. But let's just stick to your prescriptions. I need you calm and quiet while Panastate is being developed. I know being a Prescott is a burden. Yada, yada, yada. Don't fuck up, son. Your father. What a lovely guy.
Too bad Nathan isn't more like his sister.
Oh, what's his sister saying?
She sounds awesome. And far away.
Dobo Bem from Brazil. It's been so long. Send me some pictures. I miss you. Yes. You've been in trouble. Something about being legal, eh? And other stuff.
Yes, Nathan sure needs diet pills. This is strong stuff.
It's expensive as well. $250?
Wow. Kiss ass much, Principal Wells.
Nathan, I'd like to apologize for the recent accusation. Your name and record speaks for itself. Sometimes students will use that to make their own name at Blackwell. I know your father was upset while I have assured him that you will never bring a weapon into school. I don't want you distracted from school, and I am certain that the matters will be settled by the end of the week. If you have any questions, you know I'm always available to talk. What a guy. What a guy. Where the heck? Is there anything in here?
I'd cry too if I had him for a father and had to wear that suit.
Shots fired at the suit.
Holy shit. That's the gun Nathan used on Chloe.
A gift from someone? Anyone?
Nathan Prescott. All American teen.
Butts and boobs. Oregon's best boobs. Brand new shots from Crystal. I mean, it's not very well, not very discreetly hidden, but okay.
Nathan took this from Kate's altar. Why? What is with this dude? Yes, I would be cool with having this high-tech projector. These films all have a dark pattern.
What the heck are we missing? We got stuff. We can look at these photos.
Oh, man. That dickhead stole one of my selfies.
Why is one of our selfies posted up on the wall?
That looks like a totally fun show. Even Nathan has a light side.
Okay, what have we missed? We haven't looked at the photos.
Nathan likes his tortured subjects way too much.
We've looked at the pills. We've looked at everything on the computer desk. I guess we would look.
Let's see what Nathan hides in here.
Well, that didn't do anything for us. We've looked at the posters, we've looked at the DVDs, we've looked at the porn, and the photos, and the book, and the projector, and the lamp, and the MP3 player, and the drawers, and everything, I think. Apart from the scratch marks.
What the hell are all those marks on the floor?
Has the couch been moved? Yes. Yes, we're gonna move the couch.
Oh, yes, little phone. You are mine now.
Who hides the phone behind the couch? Who doesn't have the phone on them? Is my question. All right.
I have Nathan's phone, so I can show it to Chloe. Well, before Nathan comes back.
Yeah, who keeps their phone in a sealed plastic bag behind their couch? Like, what is that about? Okay, Chloe, how are you going? How's it doing? How are you hanging?
Damn, Max, you're finally back. I got worried. So, what did you find?
His room was clean and creepy. Check this out.
Boom, Nathan. We got you by the balls, fucker.
Oh, shit.
What are you doing in my dorm?
Nothing.
You're such a nosy bitch, Max.
Stop hey, right hey, there. Hey.
Make me ho. Max, I got this.
Get the fuck out of my face.
Oh, shit. Who goes in for the headbutt?
You are so fucking dead.
And how has no one searched this kid for guns yet? Oh, shit. Warren. I'm gonna stay out of it. Warren could freaking... Oh, do we want to stop him? I don't know. He had a gun. But I feel like if we want Warren to not get in, like, ridiculous amounts of trouble, we should stop Warren.
Warren, stop it! Come on!
Oh, oh,
my head. Why are y'all looking at me like that, huh? You and you, you're all dead.
Let's go, now.
Plus, my dad is on his way. You're all fucked. He owns you.
He's gonna find out real quick that
Even
we've got.
Nathan definitely deserved a beating. We should try to be better than that.
That's true, but on the other hand, Max, we now have Nathan's phone. It's not gonna take long before he realizes it's not there, and then he's gonna link it to the fact that we took it. So if we did go back and let Warren beat Nathan a bit more, maybe he wouldn't get to go back to his room, and maybe he instead would go to, like, the local hospital, or maybe the just on-campus hospital, and then maybe we'd have more time to look at stuff. But either way, I think we may have made the right choice. I don't think there is a right choice, but I think we made the one of the choices, I guess. Oh, jeez.
Damn. That was intense.
It was.
Warren, thank you so much.
For what?
For headbutting Nathan Prescott. That was awesome.
That was pretty awesome.
I almost went crazy there. Like Nathan.
You're not anything like him.
Good to know. So where are you going? I better stick with you guys. Just in case you need me to get my Hulk on again. Or should I call the cops on Nathan?
No police. Not yet. So maybe you better,
Warren, me and Max have to do this on our own. No offense.
It's cool. Whatever I can do to help.
What you can do is find out anything you can about Nathan's father.
I'm on it. Between the snow and eclipse, I'm assuming the apocalypse is around the corner.
And thank you. Seriously. I'll call you later.
You better. I'm feeling pretty alpha now.
Yes, you are.
Man, that guy is so fucking in love with you.
I know.
He really did give a serious beatdown to Nathan.
It was a little scary to watch him do that.
Now let's make a date with Frank.
Will he even answer you?
Frank always answers when he wants money. Like I said, Frank wants to see me right now.
Let's not keep him waiting. I hate seeing those poor whales like that.
Me too. I just think of their families in the ocean out there looking for them. Well, that asshole is gonna help us find Rachel.
Or what? You'll actually shoot him? Chloe, do not count on my rewind. Seriously.
Obviously, I'm not counting on you. That's why I have a gun. And I might even save you someday.
About time.
I am so going to hit you. There's no way we could have guessed this is what would happen to us when we grew up.
I'm looking forward to the day when we can just go on a road trip to Portland.
Fuck yeah. You, me, and Rachel.
Absolutely. So let's play this cool, okay? Just pay Frank his money, and then we can get that code for the book from him. That's all.
Got it. No dicking around.
Let's roll.
Is this the guy whose dog we killed last episode? Hopefully he doesn't know it was us. Oh no, his dog's alive.
Frank doesn't need tinted windows when they're this dirty.
The dog's there. The dog might be pissed, but the dog's there. Let's take a quick little nosy round.
Can't see inside with this shit blocking the view.
I think that's our purpose. We got some garbage.
Take the trash out sometime, dude.
This is where Frank ponders his existence and gets drunk.
Okay. Hey, Frank. Open up. Can I not knock?
Oh, look. The Wonder Twins. You should have come alone.
She's my partner.
Yeah, or bodyguard. So let's get to business. Where's my fucking money?
Keep money, give money. Why is this an option? I thought the idea was we give him the money. I'm just gonna... Well. Do we keep the money and try to get the codes first? Or do we give him the money and then... We'll keep the money.
I don't have the money. Yet.
Oh, really? Then why did you text me that you did?
Because I wanted to tell you in person.
Oh, I'm truly touched, Chloe. Now, why are you losers really here?
We just want to ask you some questions.
You have some serious lady balls. No. Jesus, okay. But I'm not getting you high.
Frank, we're not here to get high.
No, you don't look like the type. Not like Chloe here. So what do you hardy boys want?
Just the names of some of your clients.
Oh, is that all? Oh, well, why didn't you just tell me? How about I just give you the keys to my RV while I'm at it?
You don't get it? Help or else. I'm sorry, you already did. Oh. I don't think antagonizing him is going to help. Threatening him, I don't think he's the guy who's going to be threatened by Max. You don't get it? I'm sorry.
Listen, Frank. I'm sorry to be such a nuisance, but this is important.
Yeah, everything's important these days. But I can tell you're not bullshitting me.
There's no time for that, Frank. I just need a little bit of information.
Yeah, well, it always starts with just a little. And Chloe here knows all about that, don't you?
Come on, Frank, this isn't about me now.
Yeah, right, okay. Both of you are giving me a headache. No deal.
Frank, we didn't come here to fight. This is so much bigger than us.
What, you come in peace? After you aimed a fucking gun at me and then pulled the trigger.
No bullets? You scared me? Owl's hideout helping Chloe. I'd say helping Chloe.
I was helping Chloe after you threatened to cut her, remember?
You know, you're lucky all I brought was a knife. Otherwise, you and your girlfriend wouldn't even be bothering me. You really think you're tough shit, girly.
I didn't know what I was doing.
Dude, get off her ass. She was protecting me. You've got a knife and God knows what else. Are you really afraid of Max here?
I'm not afraid of anybody except my maker. And you little bitches think you can outsmart me? Why, because I'm trailer trash? You're Blackwell trash, and it's time to take you out.
Calm down, Frank. Let's just
Don't
talk.
Don't you ever tell me what to do. Get it, bitch? Get it?
Step the fuck back now! Oh my god!
Gosh! Yeah, you actually shot me. I wasn't gonna hurt you. Oh, this fucking hurts. Oh, it hurts.
Chloe, you shot him.
I know.
You're both fucking crazy. What do you want?
We just want the code for your account book.
Now!
Fine, whatever. Just put the goddamn gun down. You already shot me, all right? There. Now leave me alone, all right? Just get out of my life.
Do you want us to call an ambulance, or...
No, thanks. You know what? I'll manage somehow without the police.
Oh, right.
Let's bounce.
Well, that looked fun. Can we, like, look at the code and rewind? Because he's a bit of a douche,
Shit.
But...
This could have gone way worse, but... Frank might be more dangerous to Chloe now. Yes, Max, you can change all this if you want.
Can we look at the stuff we need and then go back? That makes more sense. But I guess not, no.
Chloe, are you okay? Sorry, I just keep thinking about shooting Frank in the leg.
Please don't. You saved us. Frank is lucky. We have to keep moving forward.
This is true.
I better focus on this board and start tying these clues together.
Gather info on a character by selecting all the correct clues for each section. There's a specific number of clues to select.
Oh. Thanks to David's own investigation, I should be able to find out what Nathan did during the party's week.
Okay. Gather info on a character by selecting all the correct clues. For each section, there is a specific number of clues to select. Okay.
Thanks to David's own investigation, I should be able to find out what Nathan did during the party's week.
That is a lot of clues. So we've got to look at all of these and select the ones that are relevant. But we haven't been told how many we need to select. Okay.
I hope in this case that David has good tracking skills.
Okay.
Look at all these license plates. I hope he was tailing Nathan.
TWLCHTZN. Was that the same one that was on there? No, it's close. But not quite.
At least David was finally going after the right suspect.
So I'm guessing this is all of the information, all of the files and documents that we found in David's stash. These are the pictures David took. Okay.
David should have done way more than take photos of Kate.
Blackwell Academy, parking. Although there does seem to be a lot of stuff about Kate here, so I think we might be selecting, like, all the Kate files?
Maybe he was trying to help Kate in his own messed up way.
Kate M follows same path to class every class. Overheard Kate and Dana talking about supplies to the Vortex Club party. Drugs? Watch Kate with her church group. She knows the Bible. Kate says stays in the bathroom longer than her other students. Drugs? Saw Kate helping Jefferson after class. Don't trust grown men with goatees. Okay. Kate has kept to herself since the Vortex Club party. Not even church. Drugs? Try talk to Kate after the party. She got upset and ran. Guilty. Oh, okay. So let's select the ones that are to do with Kate and the drugs.
Does David know what's going on with Rachel, or is he just paranoid about everybody?
Rachel has been cutting class all week. Frank and Rachel meet once again. Rachel avoids her dormitory. Followed Rachel to the lighthouse. Rachel avoids her dormitory. Followed Rachel to the lighthouse. Arcadia Bay police report for Rachel Amber. Okay. We don't know
of
a lot
course,
about Rachel Amber.
I'm a suspect. Proving David sucks as a detective. Sorry.
And then we'll go over here.
David really has been on Rachel's ass for a while. She should have been upset.
I was surprised to get an unscheduled visit from Rachel Amber. She seemed quite upset and claimed that David Madison was following her and taking photographs. David would deny this, and given the questionable company Rachel has been keeping, I'm not certain I can believe her right now. And then we got this map up here.
You need to get rid of these damn cameras, David.
Okay. So we've selected everything to do with Rachel. We could select... we've selected everything to do with Kate. We could select the things to do with Rachel as well.
Looks like this isn't the right combination.
Okay, so we need to select three clues. Alright, let's... middle mouse button to deselect all. Okay, let's deselect everything. Let's try selecting the stuff to do with Rachel. So, this, and then maybe the license plates?
Looks like David was tracking somebody's car. Maybe even Nathan's. Good clue.
Maybe... Oh, okay, let's try this. Let's try... Well, these... The number plates on the car and the coordinates didn't match. I was going to select this one, and this one, but I don't think that's quite going to work. Maybe... Maybe this one, and then the map?
No. This is not working.
Max, there's no logical link between those clues.
I mean, it's somewhat logical. Maybe that's Kate's car? Okay, let's teach like these. I have a feeling it's not us. There's only one thing about us there. There's only one that kind of links to Nathan. The car could belong to Kate. Let's try select.
I'll have to analyze these plates and coordinates to see if Nathan was under David's surveillance. Spies are us.
There's NDR there. TWLGOCHTZN. They are not the number plates that we saw in the coordinates over here. No. So I don't think they match at all. And there's not much to be gained from that picture. Although it could look... That picture does have us in it. So it could be... This one... Some tricky detective work. Let's unselect everything. We've tried these two with Kate and then the truck with Rachel. We have to find out about a specific character. Let's try us. We'll select this one. We'll select this one. And then I gather it's not our... Maybe this is our car?
Nope. Maybe I should try to link other clues together. I'll have to analyze these plates and coordinates to see if Nathan was under David's surveillance. Spies are us. And that's all she wrote.
I have no idea how those connected.
Can we find some clues about Nathan in here?
So we connected the coordinates, which didn't have a license plate anywhere. Then we connected the car. And then the picture of Nathan? We did it. I have no idea how those connect up, but we did it.
I have to analyze Nathan's messages. What could help me unlock this phone?
Okay, so this time we're looking for clues to unlock the phone?
There's got to be some good shit in his phone. I just need the code to unlock it.
Okay.
Couldn't hurt to give this PIN code a whack.
That is true. That seems like a good one. So we'll select that. We'll select the phone. And then the paper? Let's have a look.
Oh, so busted. It's good to see the Prescotts can't cover up all their tracks.
Disciplinary warning report. Dear Mr. and Mrs. Prescott, we regret to inform you that Nathan Prescott has disrupted various classes over the past month, despite repeated warnings and leniency. Due to a crude outburst in Mrs. Hoyder's class... intro to literacy, literature, not literacy, please see the attached file for reports. Okay, that seems completely not even remotely related to the phone.
Holy shit. Nathan is seriously unhinged. But those numbers might be useful.
They might be. One of those numbers could be the code. So
this
select
is the Vortex
that.
Club party where Nathan drugged Kate. Did he do the same thing to Rachel at another party?
Vortex Club party, October 4th, Blackwell Academy, 8 p.m. I don't see any connection between that and the PIN number.
If there is a dark room, we better find it. It's a good thing Chloe slipped all these files on her flash drive. There's a lot of numbers in here.
There are a lot of numbers there. One of them could be the phone number?
Max. Let's blow this code up and go home.
Oh, we did it! Okay, cool. Alright, let's do Frank's clues.
Let's look at Frank's drug deals during the week of the party.
Okay.
Frank's account book. But the client names are encrypted.
So I'm guessing one of these clues will be a decryption. This looks like a long list.
There's no doubt she loved him in some way.
I will switch that over to there. Frank B., hope you read this first thing in the morning. Sorry about last night. I was being a monstrous bitch. I took it out on you and poor Pompidou? Is that the dog's name? There's a lot of weird shit going on in my life, and sometimes I feel like I'm never going to get out of Arcadia Bay. Thank God for you. You're one of the best things I have here, and I smile when I think of us together. Let's just drive out of here forever. Love you always. Heart, Rachel Amber. Okay.
Rot must stand for Rottweiler. That does fit Nathan. Rotten.
Oh, okay. So we've got. Oh, I see that. Rot Nathan. So this is the code names. This is the encryption for the names. Okay. Okay. So let's select that. Let's select the book.
Yes, the game is on.
Oh, that's it. Okay.
Now, talk to us, account book. Tell us everything.
Okay. Let's all look. Nathan, what's up? Pussies can't fucking fight. You fuck up my dorm, I kill your scholarship. Okay. Fight? F-I-T-E? I like it. Okay. Have we got all of these to read still? I even killed my plant, Lisa. What? We don't have time to read these. We'll read these later on. This is... We've got some investigational work to do.
Any deal Frank made with Nathan or the Vortex Club.
Okay, so we gotta find deals that Frank made with Nathan or the Vortex Club. We've seen this one.
Names and see how Nathan fits in with all this.
So we're looking for
Frank sure
rot.
Is keeping his customers satisfied.
Rot. There we go.
Open a store.
9:30, 10 p.m. Rot. That's Nathan. $65. Let's select that one. Let's take a look at these. Let's try and select
Everybody
the ones that have
in
Nathan.
Arcadia Bay must be high. That explains a lot.
Greyhound spending a lot, but there's no rot there. Who the heck is Greyhound? Is it someone we know? Greyhound is Mick. Okay. I'd laugh if we just said, like, Mr. Jefferson. This makes so much sense
if
now.
If Frank applied this kind of detail to his life, who am I to talk?
Okay, no rot.
I wonder what dog name Frank would have given me.
Rot. $68. Okay.
I'm getting a contact high just reading this.
No rot.
Hmm. Two deals with Nathan on the same day?
And then rot Target again.
Supplies, no doubt.
On the 10th of the 4th for $900.
Oh, yes. These are all the times and places for Frank and Nathan's deals. That's it, Max.
Okay. Okay, so we have Nathan's clues and David's clues. Let's do David's clues.
Great. Now, how do I find out which car is Nathan's?
He has a lot of clues. Let's look at the coordinates.
Yep, another car David was tracking.
Okay, so these are coordinates tracking this number plate?
Who else was David tracking here?
TPFTHLK. Let's check all four of these.
Why the hell are you following these people?
That one looks like the one we saw earlier.
To where?
SXFTNDR, okay. And then I'm guessing we just have to find
that's
a car.
Definitely Chloe's car.
Okay, so that's Chloe's car, which links to this one up here. Okay.
Of course Nathan drives an SUV. Overcompensating, as usual.
I don't think we need to find out information
There's
on where
Nathan
Chloe's been.
Dealing to the kids right out in the open.
So I don't see selecting them as being any good.
Interesting. Is this Nathan's car?
TWLGHTZN. That's what we saw earlier. Let's select that one. And then what's that like up here? No. This one? Yes. Let's select that one. And then maybe like the picture of Nathan?
Damn.
No?
I must have missed something. Hmm. Who does this car belong to?
SXFTNDR.
Wow, sir. This looks like an expensive machine.
Okay, maybe this one?
Come on. Deduce Nathan's license plate number, then match it up with the coordinates.
Oh, so we don't know that this is Nathan's car. Okay, let's deselect these. Let's try... We know which one's Chloe's car. Let's try this one. The SXF. Or SFX, whatever it is. And then I think that was the last one. And then maybe link that up with Nathan?
Okay, this is just sad.
What you want?
Looks like this is not relevant at all.
Hmm. Oh, maybe with just Nathan's car.
Oh, yes.
Oh, there we go.
Finally getting somewhere. Chloe, let's plug in these numbers and see if they lead to an actual address.
Aye, aye, Captain. Here we come, Rachel.
Okay. Oh, we're back at the clue board. I was kind of hoping we'd done, but okay. Let's check out Nathan's clues. This looks like the last set.
Start hacking.
Okay, so now we actually have to get into the fun. Let's unlock. Okay, we need to enter a pin, and I'm assuming we'll find it somewhere in here. USA Mobile, SIM pin 1111. Make sure to change it, so you may have changed it. The puck is 87, is that 887808? And then prepaid phone card. Oh, is that 87897? I think that's a 9, that one there. Okay, let's try. He might not have changed it. He might have been so lazy to leave it as 1111.
Oops. Bad code.
Okay, I guess not. This one has a lot of codes on it. But he has circled 9535. So let's try 9535.
Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy.
Okay. What was on this one? Blackwell Academy student information sheet. Nathan Joshua Prescott? There's a lot of numbers on here. I doubt he'd use his GPA. Nathan just doesn't seem like that kind of guy. And 7068 maybe? Like the last three digits? Who uses the last four digits of their phone number? He may have used his date of birth, 1995. We'll try that. It's a very weak, very, very weak PIN number if you use your date of birth, but...
You locked it, dumbass.
Oh, come on. Okay. 542 is highlighted, it's red. Let's just try 0058. Oh, we gotta enter the puck. Okay, so the puck is 878-978-08. 878-978-08. 808? 878. Like a 5? Oh, I've forgotten. What was it? It's 878-978-08. 878-978-08. Okay. 878-978-08. Right?
Booyah. Let's find out what Nathan Prescott is.
Oh, wow. Okay, that's it. All right. What's up? Need the G. Okay, cool. Bitch, you sold my water, asshole. Calm down. Bring it to me. Bringing it. Stay away. Pigs on the beach. I assume he means fresh.
Yes. This is all about Nathan trying to score for the Vortex Club party.
You home? Got to party tonight. Home. On the way. Load to blow. To bowl. Load to bowl.
Nathan was jonesing hard the night of the party. He didn't have enough drugs.
Hey, I need to score ASAP. I don't make house calls. You have a car. No time. Charge me double. Damn right. Have the cash on you. No fucking around. Give me the address. I'll call you to give you the exact directions. In transit. Get that money out.
Drug dealer drama.
You up, bro? No shit. What you need? Peruvian flak. Skido acid. Okay. You're paying night prices. Don't make me wait. Sorry for being a dick. Need more stuff. You home? Yes. Don't come. Fuck off.
God, Nathan. You're out of control.
Hey, need weed, etc. Now, calm yourself. You tweaking. Soon, hook a brother up, please. Meet beach. Be cool this time.
So it was you. Now I can officially call you a psycho stalker.
Keep your smart mouth shut about everything, or I'm coming for your ass. I know where you sleep.
No, Nathan. It's time for you to watch out.
Hey ho, feminazis will be exterminated. Watch out.
Is this from Nathan's father?
Please don't contact me at work. I've told you before, and being high is not an excuse anymore. This is a business, not just a hobby. You want me to treat you like an adult who can do things on his own? Impress me. I'd like nothing more than to be proud of you. I'm not there yet. Okay. Jeez. What is this?
Go through all this data and you can find out where Nathan took Kate after the party.
Okay. I'm going to sit back. It says 0 out of 3 in the top right hand corner there. So I assume we have to select 3. Looking at this, we seem to be split into 3 sections. It's like these half papers at the top. the slips in the middle with the flyer, and then the pictures at the bottom. So I assume we have to pick one of each, which makes our work a little bit easier because there is a lot of stuff here. So I guess let's just have a look and see what's here. All right, so these are all the texts. I assume the date and time might be relevant. Let's have a look at one of these. Yeah, we have the date and time as well. And then the flyer also had a date and time.
Was the 4th.
October the 4th. So the 4th of the 10th. But then again, I think these dates will be written in the US layout. So it'll be the 10th of the 4th. Or the 10/4. So, which ones have 10/4? This is 10/4. Let's select that one. It says 3, so I don't think I have to select the flyer. I think I have to find one of these papers that also has the 4th. That one has the 4th at 5:40 p.m. What time was this one? This was 10:26 p.m. So that was a lot later. 10:07. 9:30. 10:07. 10:07. 10:04 at 11 p.m. $250. So this one is the deal that took place after this text message. And then I'm assuming there was pictures. And the pictures, I guess, were where the deal went down. So we have to find one that was on the 10th of the 4th at around 11 p.m.
I know Nathan wasn't looking for Bigfoot in the forest.
The 10th of the 1st.
Somebody is stocking up on gas. Why?
There's 410 at 9:54. Let's try that one.
Max, there's no logical link between those clues. No doubt that Nathan stays in his dorm room.
That's the 4th at 7:25. Little too early.
Not much out there.
And then the 4th of the 10th at 10:56 p.m. Oh yeah, there we go. Whew! Okay. Jeez.
This is definitely the place.
That was way too much investigating.
Nope. Nothing, Max. There's nothing here. Just a shitty old barn.
Let's keep searching and find out who owns this haunted barn.
I'm on this. Hold on. Somebody named Harry Aaron Prescott.
I'm shocked. Should we call the police?
Fuck that. You know the police here are like Nathan's private security, right?
That's so messed up.
As you've noticed, this whole town is messed up. We can't trust anybody, except each other. So we have to go out to that farmhouse by ourselves.
I was afraid you'd say that. We could call Warren since he kicked Nathan's ass.
It's just the two of us, nobody else. And I'm not scared at all. You have the power. I feel like we're this close to finding Rachel. We have to find her, Max.
We will. But remember, my power isn't infinite. We still have to be careful. Do you hear, Chloe?
Yes, sir.
Holy shit, this is scary.
I know. But we're here. Let's go find the best way in.
Whoa, check this out. Fresh tire tracks.
Dude, somebody was just here.
Then we need to get in that barn.
Okay, Chloe, I don't think there's any point looking at you. We need to find a way into the barn.
Now, why would somebody run all that electricity into an old empty barn?
I assume there is something in the barn worthwhile. Thanks for pulling me off, Nathan. Talking about going ape, I've deserved to beat down. Oh, geez, you're a wise grasshopper. Thanks, wasn't exactly doing stuff. You need to pay your hero's dues. I'll let you know, we need costumes, yada yada yada, and I have to cool myself down. Okay, thank you, Warren. He's such a nice guy. All right. The car is probably useless. We need to find a way. And let's take a look at this car, because this is definitely not ours.
Watson, we can safely assume that this ancient vehicle is not our suspect.
Okay. Good to know. Can we... We can't jump. That's a thing. This bird could well be of interest. Also, maybe just take
Max,
a photo.
Get over here before I torch this place.
Oh, I'm coming. I'm coming. I have a picture of a bird if you need it.
Chloe is so damn fearless. Where does that come from? These are thick tracks and definitely fresh.
Okay.
Nathan's SUV?
Maybe. I like Chloe called us back for no reason. What a guy. All right, here we go. Seems like a bit of a weak spot. Should probably talk to the farm
Chloe,
architect.
I found
about getting
the front
that fixed.
Door. Come on. Oh, yes. Maximus rules.
I do rule.
God, this is way too Blair Witch. I have goosebumps all over.
Come on, Supermax. Hey, check out this old chest.
A little louder, Chloe. Jeez, that is ancient.
Jackpot. Old shit.
No, look closer.
Harry Aaron Prescott and family donate new library to Arcadia Bay. Prescott Industries celebrate grand opening. The Prescotts bring bomb shelter boom to town.
My scrapbook. You search for more clues and I'll scope out the area.
What could possibly be in this bomb?
Yes, old Prescott clippings. But that can't be the only thing here.
This looks suspicious as heck.
Nothing here.
Nothing here? That looks like a flipping tunnel that leads underground, but it's not. Okay. The electricity comes in over there. Does it run? Can we, like, it's very dark. I don't think I can kind of see it going anywhere. Oh, that's going to open the door. What is up here?
Ah, the good old days.
Eggs, bacon, sugar, coffee, cocaine, tobacco, and milk. Good to see that cocaine's the most expensive on the list. Flipping cocaine prices these days. Way too high. Is this my secret trapdoor?
Whoa. What is this?
Yeah, it is.
It's totally brand new. Why?
Because this is where they store the cocaine. They bought
no,
it
Supermax.
When it was £2 back in the day.
You can't open this with your bare hands.
Now, or $2, should I say. And now they're going to sell it for quadrillions.
Okay, Chloe. I found some kind of hatch, but it's locked. I got this. I hope.
Okay. So that's hooked to where exactly? That goes up there. And then that's it? How? Is there a ladder somewhere we can climb up? Like, maybe get up there? Or does that link to something else? Let's keep looking. What have we got? We got a pitchfork.
Pretty sure this old pitchfork won't open a padlock.
I mean...
Try again, Max.
Maybe. Okay. We got a... Oh, can we, like, climb? Yes, we can climb. Okay, here we go.
Chloe, can you give me a hand?
Sidekick at your service.
I'm gonna like swing on this.
Away, Supermax.
I dig having minions.
Cause we're not just gonna be able to pull it, are we? That's not gonna work at all. We're gonna pull this. What the heck was this?
That looks sturdy enough to stand on.
Looks can be deceiving.
That looks
Max.
Sturdy enough to stand on.
Okay. Now, what the heck are we going to do with this thing? Nothing? Where'd it go? Oh, it goes round. Oh, here it is. We are not going to be able to pull that with enough force.
I can't pull this rope without tearing my flesh off.
I was going to say.
I need to hook this up to something heavier.
Okay. Chloe, I've got an idea. You go out and buy about 17,000 crates of Jaffa Cakes, bring them back, and then once I put on at least 10 stone, I will jump off with this rope, and that will more than certainly open the hatch. Deal? No? Okay. We won't do that then. Can I climb up here? I can take a photo of this owl. I'm so glad we have priorities. I'm surprised. Oh, look at the owl. I'm surprised the owl's still in here. Surprised we didn't wake him. What a nice guy. I got an achievement. Manually exposed. Alright, how am I gonna I assume I have to get out there somewhere, or maybe, oh, here's a hook. Do we have to, rope, the rope stops there, how's it go?
Max, use your rewind and get that motor back up there.
Oh, okay. Thanks for telling me, game. I'm so- okay. We took too long. We fiddled around for too long. The game was just like, here you go, here's the answer. Boom. Okay. Or maybe not. Ah, here we go. Oh.
So that didn't work at all.
Oh. Okay. We'll rewind. I don't think we were supposed to do that. So we'll rewind and we'll try this again.
Talk about heavy metal. I could use that to open the hatch.
Here we go. Yes, we attach it, then we push it off. Right. That's good. Right. Here we go. We did it. We've done it. Here we go. Pull. There we go. Okay.
MacGyver strikes again.
All right. Let's have a look. How much cocaine are we talking? Place your bets now. If there's just Rachel Amber's body under here, I'm just gonna be like, what? That cannot be the, oh my. What
is this?
I think we figured out where the power's going.
Do I even need to say how weird this is?
He just did. Who built this kind of place?
A Prescott, of course.
What the actual heck? Some secret concrete basement in a barn in the middle of nowhere? Is this vault?
This bunker is so surreal.
Number one? Is this Fallout? I don't know the code.
This is too heavy to break, so I'll need a code.
Is this what we guess? Oh, we have to. Okay, so some of these are worn down. 2, 4, and 5 are all worn down. 2, 4, 5 I thought it was a 4-digit code, but a 3-digit code is much easier to crack. It's one of these three combinations.
Oh, no, it didn't work.
4, 5, 2
Oops.
Okay, so we tried.
Okay, so it's locked.
Oh, that's fine. Okay, so we tried 2, 4, 5
Some numbers look faded, so I just have to get lucky.
We tried 5, 4, 2 Let's try 2, 5, 4 Now let's try 4, 5, 2 4, 5, 2 What?
Think.
We tried 2, 4, 5 Didn't we? To start with, we tried 2, 4, 5 Yeah.
No, it didn't work. Some numbers look faded, so I just have to get lucky.
2, 4, 5, 5, 4, 2, 425. Did we try 425? I think we did. Maybe like 524? I think we tried that just now, didn't we?
Oops. Bad code. Wrong code.
452?
You can do it, Max.
Maybe 254?
So I just have to get lucky.
What do you mean get lucky? This is impossible. 254, 542, 452. Watch when it's like 999. 2, 4, and 5. I assume the same. I mean, not to delve too deep into this, but the code could have been changed. It could be like 222 for all we know. I'll try like 555. No, that's gonna work.
Bad code. Wrong code. Some numbers look faded, so I just have to get lucky.
What? I'm fairly certain I tried 542 seconds. What the heck? What the heck?
Open sesame.
Stocked and ready for the apocalypse. This must have cost.
You locked it, dumbass.
Come on.
We locked what? The door, okay.
Jeez. What the hell is this?
Let's look at this stuff.
More survivalist supplies.
Cereals. Pretty sure you're not allowed to call cereal that.
Water supplies.
Well, I guess you could.
Like in David's garage bunker.
I wonder, do you reckon the word like cereal is trademarked in any
Look
meaningful way?
Cans.
Do you reckon anyone's like, there's a brand
David
of cereal called cereal?
The same store. Whoa. This says it all about Nathan. He needs help.
Dear Mr. Prescott, as Nathan's primary psychiatrist over the last 5 years, I feel that I should stop seeing your son, as you have disregarded my rather dire and immediate suggestions for his and others' well-being. You may well know that Nathan's challenges, yet you have a few psychologists on the road to play in the mental health. I have your support, I cannot treat Nathan, something about you and your wife, no matter, I am always available when you decide to stop being a bag of douchebags.
Duct tape in a bunker is always a bad sign.
Rachel here.
What the heck is this place? Photographs? What?
That's an original signed illustration. Fits perfect in here.
What is this? You know, I thought the end of last episode, where like Chloe was in the wheelchair and it was like dun dun dun, was like the weirdest thing this game could possibly do, but what the heck is this? A photo? Is this just a big...
I guess Nathan needs the most expensive printer in the world.
We're just printing big photos?
That son of a bitch.
What the heck is this? 1.35 million dollars for the construction of this bunker. Jeez.
Let's see what's in here. Oh my god.
Is that Kate?
No.
Tied up for a photograph? Chloe? You wanna have a look at this?
Oh yeah, school suspension is a deal breaker in the Prescott family.
Something about the Vortex Club party, blah, 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 from his father. You're still my son. Fulfill our destiny. The day is coming sooner than you think, so be prepared to step into that responsibility. Okay. We got more pictures.
Talk about tortured.
I am so excited to find out what the heck this place is.
Prescott's in creepy art.
It's the place that's been the end of all the episodes. Oh, at the end of all the episodes, they show us the the files.
Come on, let's see what this shit is all about.
We are.
Rachel, Kate, and Victoria.
Okay. A binder marked Victoria, but it's empty.
Is she our next mark?
The next one says Kate.
Oh no, Kate. No.
God, I should have killed that bastard back there.
Kate wasn't the first. All those binders are filled with other victims. Victoria has to be next. Nathan must be planning to dose her tonight at the Vortex Club party.
Rachel. This can't be real. These are all post shots, right? Right?
Chloe, look at her face. She's out of it.
Maybe Nathan paid her a shitload of cash to do this. She probably would have.
I don't think so. Why is he putting her in the ground like that? Where?
The junkyard. Max, we have to find that spot now. Then we can see what he did. There's no way she's dead. No way. She posed for those pictures, Max. I know it. Please, let's go.
We've got a little bit more searching to do, Chloe.
Rachel, Kate, all these files. This place actually feels evil. Ah, the Apocalypse Entertainment System. Oh, shit. That's Nathan's jacket. Has he been here recently? These newspapers are all about Rachel and Kate.
Arcadia Bay Beacon. Okay.
Somebody likes their whiskey.
What the heck is this place?
I've never seen so much pricey equipment before.
Yeah, that lens looks expensive.
So who's using this fancy tripod?
I mean, the tripod looks less fancy than the lens, but okay. What? Coming up next, Max Caulfield sporting this year's designer shirts. Flipping, I don't know. I don't watch runway stuff. As you may
this
have guessed.
This must be the crap that Nathan gets from Frank. Needles. Gross.
Okay, that's that. Alright, I don't want to do that. Stop. Okay, fine. Fine. Oh gosh, are we dead? We just need to get out of here. We need to go out. We need to find flipping where the heck they buried Rachel or whatever the heck is going on. We need to figure this out. I'm coming, Chloe. I'm not gonna lie, it seems like a pretty bad idea on Nathan's part to take photos of all this. But I am so...
Chloe, slow down! Wait for me!
What the heck is gonna be under here now?
I know exactly
what
we're
gonna find. What is this? We were here not so long ago. Episode
Look,
two, was
this
it?
This is it.
Are you gonna help me, Max?
Chloe, stop. Look.
There cannot be a body here.
Please, no.
Come on.
Oh. That smell.
Rachel. Oh, Rachel, no, please not her.
Chloe.
Rachel, why?
I'm sorry, Chloe. I'm so sorry.
I loved her so much. How can she be dead? What kind of world does this? Who does this?
Oh, that cannot be the end of today's episode. Okay, it's not. That's not the end of the episode. Or maybe it is, but I really hope it's not. We have to go. We have to, like, confront Nathan. Okay. And we also have to save Victoria. I mean, she is a bit of a bitch, but at the end of the day, the last two people that we know that Nathan did this to have both died, so...
Chloe, we can go right to the cops. We have proof. Fuck the police. Rachel wanted us to fight.
Fuck the police. I'm Chloe.
So we can get real justice. And revenge. The Prescotts have had this coming for 100 years, and nobody is gonna get in my way. Especially with your help. Right?
I'm with you to the end, Chloe. You know that.
Okay.
Oh, shit. This is like that eclipse.
You're right. Look at the outline.
I can't tell if they're different.
What is
there
that?
Can't be two moons.
Jesus, Chloe, look up at the sky.
Impossible.
Beautiful. I don't give a shit. The world is ending. Cool.
You're not listening. Something major is going down.
That's right. Nathan Prescott is going down.
Welcome to the end of the world, ladies. I'm glad you decided to escort me.
You look really good, Warren. Are you all right after today?
I'm glad you stopped me. Nathan is dangerous.
Where is he?
I didn't see him at the dorm again. I was held up in my room.
Dude, have you been drinking?
Well, if you consider half a beer drinking...
I think you've had a little bit more than half a beer.
Hey, hey. I know this is a bad time, but can I get one picture? I've been feeling like this might be actually the end of the world, so... I want to have something for prosperity.
Well... I don't blame you, Warren.
I know. I'm a pain in the booty. Just one picture.
Action.
We've got no time for this shit. Come on, Max.
Sorry. I just wanted to feel like a normal student after this week's ultra violence. I never hit anybody like that before. I was always the one getting my ass kicked.
Hey, we still need your expert help. If you see Nathan, text me immediately, okay? And do not let him see you.
He won't. I know how to be invisible here.
Not to me, Warren. Text soon.
If he has had only half a beer, that guy really cannot handle his alcohol. I'm just saying. Okay.
Hi.
She can't just shoot Nathan, though. Like, that cannot be how this goes down.
I didn't see any tablet with
Nathan
tablet.
Needs to pay more than just with a bullet
Chloe,
to his face.
Where the hell are you?
Okay, I'm just gonna... Let's just go past.
I hate touching all these clothes.
It is kind of nasty.
Plus some...
Hi, Stella.
Hey, Max. Welcome to the end of the world. Do you want me to check anything in?
No thanks, Stella. Have you seen Nathan yet?
No, thank God. That boy creeps me out. Wait, some girl just asked about Nathan before you came in.
Blue hair? Tall? Nathan's creepy? What girl?
What girl?
She had blue hair, dressed like a punk. I've seen her putting up those Rachel Amber posters.
Yeah, I know you're on about.
I'm stuck here, so I'm sorry I can't help you.
So why are you working at a Vortex Club party? I didn't think you wanted to be a member.
Screw that. I'm here for the job.
Anything unusual?
Do you notice anything unusual about the Vortex Club tonight?
Yeah, I noticed they don't give a shit about Kate Marsh. I'm glad for the job, but I think Principal Wells should have canceled the party. Guess I'm not cool enough.
Yes, you are, Stella. You're smart, honest, and you bust your ass for Blackwell. I hope everything turns out your way in the end.
Well, thank you, Max. I really appreciate that. Hey, your face looks so intense.
Are you okay? I am pretty intense right now.
No, I'm actually not okay. I just need to find Nathan. And don't get too close if you see him.
Hell no. This is homework, not a party. I'll text you if I spy him. Good luck.
Thanks, Stella. You're the best. All right, here we go. Party time. That is, oh, we're in the, oh, okay, we're in the pool area. Okay. Okay, where the heck is Chloe? I feel like we're a bit overdressed for the occasion.
Nathan and take him down.
I will take a drink.
Energy drinks, soda, energy drinks. I know somebody has the booze.
Courtney, is it you?
There's Courtney drinking alone, without Taylor or Victoria. I wonder why.
How's it going, Luke?
Just wish
school days.
Nathan's ass.
Luke, I almost didn't see you.
Max, you're the only person I don't mind seeing right now.
What, thanks?
I was looking for Nathan.
I've avoided almost everybody here tonight. Why are you looking for Nathan?
No big deal. It's no big deal.
No big deal.
We can't go around raising red flags.
You look pretty fucking intense.
I've been told.
I have dreams that somebody finally kicks his ass one day.
Luke, sometimes dreams come true. Today I saw Warren give Nathan an epic headbutt.
Yes, give it up for Brother Warren. Now all we have to do is drive all these goddamn Prescott vampires out of town.
That'll be hard to do when the Prescotts own the town and the Vortex Club.
I call it the Vortex Cult. Look at this crap. Dress code? VIP section? Elitist bullshit.
Preach it, Brother Luke. Okay, I have to get going. Thanks for seeing me.
No, thank you. For helping Kate. And for keeping it real. Peace out.
There's a VIP area? That is lovely.
Bigfoot on otter action.
Yep. This fight is intense. Oh, can we stop that? Hey.
Alyssa, incoming!
Again?
Oh, there we go,
that
we
was
saved
too
her.
Close. Thanks, Max. I wish you had been around earlier this week.
I'm sorry I wasn't, but there you go. We just flipping. That's like a butterfly effect? What do you mean? We just got ourselves a little extra end screen action there. We can see how many other people did that. Okay, VIPs only. I think you'll find that I am on the VIP list, girl. That's a lovely
Why
name.
Why isn't Courtney guarding the list for the VIP section?
Excuse me, but I'm going in.
Sorry, but this is the VIP section. Members only.
Okay?
I don't give a shit about being a member. I just want to talk
Victoria
to Nathan.
Victoria specifically told me not to let you in. Nice try. Too bad you're not a member.
Listen!
No, you listen. Courtney is supposed to be the VIP gatekeeper, not me. So please go.
I need to find a way to enter this bullshit club.
Hey.
I'm so not impressed by this VIP crap.
Vortex Club VIP only. Which go in? Oh, this is not the VIP area.
Hey,
oh, okay.
Max, what are you doing?
What the heck is this?
If I get
69 reasons to bang Rachel. I think we read this earlier, didn't we? Hi guys, how's it going? Yep. Yeah? Yeah? Okay. Who's talking to me? This is lovely. Justin, you're the only one who looks to be not urinating right now. What's going on?
Oh, Maximum Overdrive. About time you got here to save this lame rave. Wanna get ripped?
You look pretty ripped already, Justin. And not happy. Why did you even come tonight?
Where else could I go in Arcadia Bay on a Thursday night? Besides, Dana is here. Just not with me. So yes, this party sucks.
I guess we can just ask about Nathan
Speaking
again.
Speaking of, have you seen Nathan?
Oh, he should be freaking out in the VIP lounge with that whore text club. Fucking hate those snobby douchebags. Especially Nathan. That dude is gonna go on a rampage soon.
You might be right, so stay away from him tonight, okay? Spread the word.
Max, I know I'm twisted, but your face looks so fucking intense. And your voice sounds different. You okay? How about a quick dab?
No, I'm cool, Justin. And I have to get going. Maybe you should go chill somewhere else.
Fucking A, Maximus. You're right. I'm only torturing myself here. Plus, I'm too loaded. It's time to get my board and grind.
Always good talking to you, Justin. That was very insightful. Okay. We can't talk... Kill the press cards. Can't talk to any of the girls here. We can look at this bra.
Gross. How did this even get here?
Yes, you've
good
been
night, sweet
for like
prince.
I mean, to
Maybe
be fair,
you're not the only one who has to
you
can
see fixed. The bra. You can probably guess what's going on in there.
You don't wrap it up. We're coming
so,
in, sister.
So yeah, I mean, what's going on down here? Oh, can we? We can look at the poster.
I'd like to tear every one of these things down.
How's it going, guys? Yeah, yeah. How's it going? Alright, looks like there's nobody else who we can talk to here. There's graffiti all over the place. Everybody else is either peeing, waiting to pee, or sat on the floor looking at his shoes. So this place was 100% useless. Alright, let's get back out. Alright. Can we just kind of like... How are we going to get through here? The girl, the banner... Can we speak to her again?
God, are you mental? You can't come in.
What if I told you that I know magic? Then can I come in? No? We got her. Person at the bar. We got Brooke, who likes Warren. Probably the one who wrote the stuff in the bathroom, doesn't like us.
Hello, Brooke.
Max, I didn't expect to see you at a Vortex Club party.
I didn't expect that either, but I really need to find Nathan. Have you?
No, I haven't seen him. And I'm not looking for him, so I most likely won't tonight. I just hate that scrub. And his club.
Not the only one? Why are you here? I'll say that I'm the only one.
You're not the only one. Maybe this party will be the end of the Vortex Club.
Then I don't have to pretend like I care anymore.
Have you seen Warren tonight?
Why? You're the one going out with him.
Brooke, enough. I'm sorry Warren asked me to the movies, but you don't need to give me an attitude. I'd like to think I'm your friend.
I know. I get salty when things don't go my way.
You don't
I'm
say.
I'm selfish while you go on a roof to help save your friend.
You're not selfish, Brooke. You're just trying to live your life without all this bullshit. Like all of us here.
You seem so wise and kind of invincible this week. I think that snow and eclipse gave you superpowers. Check to see if you can fly.
I might.
I don't think having superpowers would make my life easier. With great power comes great bullshit.
I think someone needs to write that one down.
It would be pretty kick-ass.
With great power comes great bullshit.
Well, the night is still young, Brooke.
And so are we, Max. So let's plan a drone date next week.
Okay, I think that's some moves you got there. Let's try going this way then, I guess. Can we get around like this? Can we like jump in the water? No? Just push it in the water? Oh, people are gonna be pissed. Oh, there we go.
Whoa, whoa, what the fuck is going on?
Quick, go back, go back.
Okay, whoa, whoa, who stopped the music, okay?
It wasn't me! It wasn't me!
Oh my god, DJ, Drew was checking me out!
Yeah, okay. Wasn't me. Wasn't me. Rewind time. Oh, we should be... Yeah, we should still be in front. Oh, yeah, we did it. Okay, cool. Here we go. Hi, guys. How's it going in the VIP area? You two look like you shouldn't be back there. But they look like nondescript characters, so I'm just going to ignore that.
Nathan is the Vortex Club. So his ass has to be here tonight. It's
okay. That's it. What does that say?
Oh, that makes me want to pull a carry on the Vortex Club.
Fuck your selfie? I don't think sitting down is the answer. We got Zachary and Juliet, who are VIPs.
I heard they wouldn't.
So Juliet hooked up with Zachary again? She better be careful so he doesn't pull any revenge porn or something.
You dance worse than my dad.
Oh, Dana, how's it going?
Yay, Max! I can't believe you showed up. Why didn't you tell me? We could have dressed up together.
As you can tell by my outfit, I was in a hurry. Dana, have you seen Nathan around?
Hell no, I've been dancing with Trevor. Come on and dance with us. Look at Trevor trying to bust a move.
You guys look really happy together.
I think we are. He's so different than Logan. We actually talk about life. And he knows how to be safe.
I hear you, Dana. But I want you to avoid Nathan if you see him, okay?
I will if I want to have fun. I still feel sorry for him. He needs help, but not from his family.
Vortex Club?
The Vortex Club is also enabling him.
I know. Juliet wrote a story describing it like a cult, and I'm starting to think she was right. It's not fun anymore.
Sounds like you're ready for a change.
I don't need any club to be cool or have friends. Look at you. Plus, I like hanging with Trevor and his skater friends. No drama.
That sounds like a plan, Dana. I'm glad Trevor is with you tonight.
Thanks. The boy cannot dance, though. Look at that.
I know Victoria is next on Nathan's hit list.
What are you talking about? Trevor's got some moves. Okay, here we go. Logan.
Victoria, your picture so has to win.
Victoria.
Yeah, that would be wicked.
She's not going to like us, but we're going to talk to her.
I'm trying not to. Sorry, Max. Vortex Club members only.
Sorry. I'm on the guest list.
I'm taking you off.
Go fuck yourself, Victoria. I don't have time for this bullshit.
Real cute, Max. You still pissed about me taking your picture?
Do you even have a clue what's going on at Blackwell? Kate Marsh killed herself in front of you and me, everybody here.
That's not my fault, Max. Don't you even try to blame me.
I blame Nathan for dosing Kate, but nobody at that party even cared she was so wasted.
It's a fucking party. Everybody is wasted. What do you want from me?
Some humanity, Victoria.
Well, you got Nathan busted out of Blackwell, so you should be happy. And I'm the only person here who cares what Nathan is going through.
This is bigger than a problem, child.
I'm not perfect, okay? I'm a teenager at an art school. I'm only here to become a photographer and get famous.
Seems like a legit plan. You suck. I don't think that's a good way to go. Let's say you have talent. You're a nice
you
person,
talent,
Victoria.
You don't have to push people out of your way.
You don't understand. My parents own a gallery. I know how this art game has to be played. It's brutal.
No, it's art. You don't have to play their way. Mr. Jefferson doesn't talk that way, and he's famous.
Yeah, Mr. Jefferson probably won't be choosing my photo. I'm not as talented as I thought.
Yes, you are. But we shouldn't have to choose between talent and kindness. I hope.
Hard to believe, but I don't always make the best choices. Do you think it's like fate we're not supposed to be friends?
Well, I kind of know we would be friends in a different life.
Maybe, but who says we have to be enemies?
Whoever makes that decision.
That would be us, Victoria.
Well, Max Caulfield, I could always choose to let you in the Vortex Club.
I don't think that's gonna happen. But not for the reasons you think.
Oh, you look so serious.
We've got to warn her. We can't not warn her about this, can we? This seems like a very easy decision to make. Well, it seems like an easy decision from a moral standpoint, but from a fun and what would happen if we didn't tell her standpoint, we could not warn her. I feel like this could be one of those decisions where we get to the end screen and 99% of people told her about the dark room, whereas some are not going to warn her. So, I'm not going to warn her.
Never mind. It was good talking to you, Victoria.
That may have been a bad choice. Max. Wow.
You're just jealous of me because I actually do the things you can't. I put my photographs out there while you hide behind your lame retro self.
At least tell me.
We went from almost being friends for her to being like eat a dick.
Principal Wells wanted to see us Monday. It's no big deal.
Then why ask me? I haven't even seen him tonight.
Adios.
Au revoir.
Okay. And we can't even take that back. That's like set in stone now. We chose not to tell her about the dark room. Hi, Chloe.
Should I have warned Victoria about Nathan? I mean, she might be evil, but...
I'm not gonna... I want to see what happens.
There you are.
I didn't want to talk to Chloe, but
Nathan
okay.
Nathan isn't here. Nobody has seen him tonight.
He's definitely not upstairs or in the locker.
Hey, Jefferson!
Maybe he's hiding in his dorm.
Then let's bail. Nathan can't hide anymore.
So, you made it, Max.
Oh, hey, Mr. Jefferson.
Are you both okay? You look like you're on a mission.
Oh,
you could say that.
I was just looking for Nathan.
Uh-huh. I didn't know you were pals with him. I haven't seen him since this afternoon. He seemed pretty upset. I think he's still quite upset over the whole Kate situation.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Let's talk later, Max. I have to announce the winner of the contest. I do wish you would have entered.
You said.
Have to build up that resume and portfolio, but I know you will.
Thanks. I hope so.
Okay, excuse me. I'm almost on.
Let's get the hell out of here, Max.
It really seems like an odd place to announce the winner of a contest. But hey.
Okay, everybody calm down. Thank you. I appreciate it. Look, I don't want to get in the way of the party, but it's time to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes Contest. Before I do, I want to thank everybody who entered their photograph and everybody who thought about entering. This is the most important step in being an artist. Sharing your work with the world. All of you represent Blackwell Academy and everything our school stands for. As far as I'm concerned, you're all everyday heroes. The envelope, please. And the winner is...
Come on!
Max Caulfield!
Oh my, what a shocker. Victoria Chase.
Woo!
Thank you so much, Mr. Jefferson. It was your incredible photography that brought me to Blackwell, and I hope I can live up to your name and fame. I also want to thank all the students for being so dedicated in their pursuit. And I'd like to dedicate this prize to the memory of Kate Marsh. She was the real everyday hero of Blackwell. Thank you.
You suck, Victoria.
Victoria won. Big surprise. I can't believe she blackmailed Jefferson. Well, yes, I can.
Who fucking cares? Rachel is still dead, and I want Nathan's punk ass now.
Me too. Let's go check out the dormitories.
Christ, Nathan just texted me. He says there won't be any evidence left after he's done.
Shit. We have to go to the junkyard right now.
Sugar. So Nathan knows that we know. What is going on? Why were the two moons? Why is Nathan in the junkyard?
Stop stomping.
Why haven't we called the police?
Right. Just get ready to use your rewind fast if Nathan tries to jump us.
This
Rachel.
Is so creepy.
Rachel.
I love how we're using the light on the back of our phone. Oh, okay, it's a
Rachel,
bird.
I will get your revenge. I swear.
Why did Nathan come back? Why did Nathan come to the junkyard?
God, I want to fucking kill that little psycho.
Hey, do we know it's Rachel?
Focus if you're yelling.
Did we like fully unbag her or whatever and take a look to make sure it was, or are we just assuming?
Hurry.
I think we've confirmed it's Rachel because he said in the text, Rachel.
Oh god, Max, look. She's still there.
Don't look, Chloe.
Oh, Sugar! Rewind! Rewind! I can't rewind!
Chloe!
Look out!
What the fuck?
What the shit? What? Rewind! Rewind! Let me rewind!
Chloe.
What the actual fuck? They're gonna end the episode there. What? 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 Why? Oh my gosh, okay. What? Oh, jeez. We were in the majority who accepted Chloe's request. We stopped one from being up Nathan. Most people did. I didn't mean to skip there. But I accidentally clicked right click. Is this going to be us? So wait, are they working together? Or is Nathan not even close to being part of any of it? Is it all Jefferson? Are we going to die? I assume Chloe's dead for good now. Because we weren't there to rewind time. Unless we have a picture of her at the scene, which he... That makes more sense now, because he is a photographer. It makes more sense that he would have taken so many photos. The storm's still coming in. What? Episode 5 is the last episode coming soon. Flipping heck. What in the world? What? Okay. Well, with that, guys, I'm going to end this episode of Life is Strange there. Thanks for watching. If you did enjoy the video, be sure to hit like. We will be back in, I guess, about a month and a half, 2 months' time. These usually come out every 2 months. 2 months. I'll see what the heck happens in episode 5. We could have been wrong all along. Nathan could have been innocent from the beginning. It was just like completely all Mr. Jefferson. But there were letters addressed to Nathan in the bunker. What? Oh, this makes no sense. But again, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.